everybody, and welcome to the Pet Tunes YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about rats and deciding whether or not they make good pets. Now, I think rats being classed as a good or a bad pet is going to be an ongoing debate for a long time because some people love rats and some people hate them. I think it's a really big question that a lot of people have, wondering whether they're just kind of like a gerbil or a hamster when you have them as a pet, whether they are actually the kind of disease-carrying vermin that we think of when we see one in the wild. So today we're going to talk about a few things that you need to consider when thinking about getting a rat that should make it a little bit easier to decide whether a rat is a good or a bad pet for you. So be sure to put your opinions down below. Let us know if you would like to have a rat or if you've had rats in the past, and maybe what your reactions were when you have told other people that you have rats. Are they really surprised or are they really excited? I think there's probably some cool stories in there, so definitely leave us something in the comments. Now, a really important thing to know about rats is that they are very social creatures, so it's pretty much always recommended to get at least two rats so they can keep each other company. Obviously, this is a pretty big thing to consider because it means that you're gonna have to have two rats at least instead of just the one that you might have been expecting. But the good news is it generally doesn't take too much more effort to look after two rats as opposed to one. Two rats can still live in the same cage, they can eat the same food, and they generally won't have too many issues with bonding with each other, especially if you get two of the same sex, especially two females. Apparently, two females are the best for kind of getting along with no issues. Now, another thing to consider is the cage. Now, rats are pretty big. They're probably bigger than you're imagining, definitely bigger than something like a hamster or a gerbil. So their cage needs to be pretty big. Exploring and getting exercise is a really, really important part of a rat's kind of daily life. So your cage needs to be big enough that at least two rats can do a good amount of exploring and be really happy in there. It's also recommended to give your rat at least an hour of extra exercise outside their cage every single day, doing different enrichment activities, so giving them toys, giving them new foods to try, and just new things to explore in general to keep them thinking and happy. Now, obviously this means that there is quite a bit of commitment involved in having rats. You will have to make sure they get that extra exercise and enrichment every day. And obviously the big cage might become an issue if you have quite limited space. You're also probably going to have to go around and rat-proof your house, which means things like getting rid of cables that might be in the way that your rat could chew through, and just checking that your house plants aren't toxic and things like that. But the plus side of this is that rats are a super interactive pet. They are really friendly and they love to play with their humans, and they're actually known to form a really strong bond with their human, so it's a really rewarding and loving pet to have. And you might be surprised to note that rats are really good at keeping themselves clean, so there's not too much risk of them stinking up your house and spreading diseases and everything. They are actually really clean. And finally, we have a bit of a sad one. Rats have a really short lifespan. They only live for about 2 to 4 years. Now, obviously this isn't great if you're looking for a long-term pet. And there's also the issue that the one remaining rat might get really upset when their friend dies. You will have to find another companion for your remaining rat, and you might even end up having to rehome your rat if it comes to that. But of course, a lot of people don't want a long-term commitment, and the shorter lifespan can be an appealing factor in having a pet. So it's much less commitment than, for example, taking on a dog that can live for up to like 18 years. It also makes them a good pet for a child. As long as the child is obviously taught how to take proper care of the rat, they are really good with children and they make really nice first pets. And it's a good way to teach them the responsibility of having a pet and how to care for it without the kind of lifelong commitment of another animal that lives for a very long time. So those are all our rat tips today. We hope that these help you make a decision on whether rats are good pets or not. Definitely leave your opinions in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, also like and subscribe to the Pet Tunes channel. We have loads of videos on all different kinds of pets all the time. I'm gonna go off now, and I'll see you next time. Bye!